Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to tell you how to wrap your text around an object like a shape or really any line in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. Okay, now I'm in Illustrator and I'm going to create new. We'll come up here to print and then I'll choose letter. And then we'll come over here to create. Next, we'll hit L on our keyboard to get to our ellipse tool, and I'm just going to draw a big circle here. I'll hold shift to kind of make it an actual circle. And then I'll hit V and click and drag to kind of center it up on the page. Now I'll hit T to get to my text tool, and then once I'm there, I can click and drag and get to my type on a path tool. Now, one thing when you're using this, you have to make sure to get right on the edge of that circle. So I'll click once, and you can see it added a bunch of lorem ipsum on there. If you don't have that, that's a preference. I think you can turn it off and on. So if you don't have it, you'll want to type something. I'm going to type Illustrator. Okay, now I'm going to hit Command A to select all of that type. That's Control A on a PC. I'll hit Shift Command Right caret, that's right above your period, to increase the size. We can also come up here and increase it this way. We'll make it 75. Okay, now right now it is aligning to the left, so if I make it bigger or smaller, it starts from right over here. And I want it to be centered. I'm going to open my paragraph palette. If you don't have this open, you can go to Window, Type, and Paragraph. Right down here. And we'll come over here and center it. And it kind of is going to probably move it around into a place you don't really want, but that's okay. Now I'll get back on my selection tool and I'm going to get my rulers up. And to do that, it's Command R on Mac and Control R on a PC. We'll need those in a minute. Now I've got two little bars here and one bar here. And I'm going to just drag on one of these and around the circle. I'm going to put it right about here. Now I got my rulers up so that I could easily pull a guide down because I want the bottom of this R and the bottom of the I to line up. So I'll just click in the ruler area and drag to bring a guide down. I'm going to hit Z to get my zoom tool and draw around it. Then I'll use my hand, which is the space bar, to kind of move it around. All right, now I'm going to hit V to get back on my selection tool, and I'll grab this handle and kind of pull it over. And now we're pretty much lined up the way I want. Let's change the font to something else. This college block will work fine, but now we're outside of these little edges. We can either pull this around to give it more space, or we can reduce the size of our text with Shift Command left caret or comma. That's Shift Control comma with the PC. Okay, and now we'll move these a little bit more to make sure they kind of line up on that guide. Now, sometimes you want the text to go around the bottom like this. So to do that, I'm just going to copy what we already have, click off, and then paste in front with Command F. Or Control F. So we have a copy right on top of this other one. So to get it to come down here like this, you'll need this middle bar. And this can be a little bit tricky, but just click on that middle and then pull it down. You can see it's upside down now. And then just move it along the bottom like this. And it can kind of flip around, but you can always bring it back. And now I'm going to move this little handle up to give it a little more space. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. And a lot of these are kind of weird kerning. You can always click T on your keyboard and just get in between them and then option right or left arrow to change that spacing between them. I'm using my arrow to move, and then once I get in between one I want, I option arrow to change the spacing, or alt arrow. And I'll get a guide down here too. I'll get back on my selection tool, and then I'll just move this over so the tops of the I and the R line up a little better. Now the type on a path tool can be along any path. So if you just wanted to use your end tool, which is your pencil, to draw a wavy line, I've got mine pretty smooth. You can double click this and get it even smoother than that. We'll say, okay, I'm going to delete that and try again. Okay, yeah. So now we can use our type on a path to just click on that. And when you do that, you'll still have your little handles in your center point. So you can move it along the line like that. Put that up here. But if your lines aren't really smooth, you're going to have some weird text issues like that. You can always hit your A tool, which is your direct selection, and kind of change these points so that the text falls differently on those parts of the line. There we go. That looks a little better. And then, of course, you'll want to use your kerning to adjust the spacing between them. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and also the little bell after you subscribe, and you'll be notified for every video that comes out. All right, I'll see you next week. Thank you.